If you're a fan of professional wrestling, then you are in luck this weekend for a few reasons. Not only is All Elite Wrestling in town, but so is a fan event that's returning to where it all began. That is StarCast 6 at the Hyatt Regency in Schaumburg. Former and current superstars will take part in a number of events with fans. And that includes one person quite familiar to those in the Chicagoland area. Dennis Rodman is one of those who will appear at StarCast, which runs from Friday through Sunday. The former Bulls star, who helped the team to 3 NBA championships in the late 90s, had a memorable stint in professional wrestling, especially during and then after the 1998 NBA Finals 25 years ago, when the Bulls won their last title. StarCast organizer Conrad Thompson spoke to WGN News Now about having Rodman at the event and what he meant to pro wrestling during his time in WCW.
25 years ago, they created history and magic, not just the Chicago Bulls besting the Utah Jazz in the finals, but then a month later, the evil Dennis Rodman tagged up with Hollywood Hogan, who was now a bad guy, against the babyface good guy Diamond Dallas Page and Karl Malone. So to see those guys battle it on the court and then battle it in the ring, and now we get to commemorate that 25 years later, it's pretty special for NBA fans and WCW fans. It was actually the second highest grossing WCW pay-per-view of all time. Their most famous storyline was about Sting and the NWO in December of 97. But July of 98, where Dennis Rodman and Karl Malone were in the ring against each other, is still the second highest grossing event in WCW history from a pay-per-view perspective. And it just had so much mainstream coverage. I mean, every media outlet in the world, long before there was a TMZ, you know, the USA Today's and things like that, they were all there and curious about what was going to happen in wrestling, which wasn't common. You know, you didn't see highlights on an ESPN or a SportsCenter or things like that. They normally never covered professional wrestling. Dennis Rodman brought that access and exposure for WCW. So it's a big deal from a pop culture standpoint and a wrestling standpoint.
Rodman is one of over 50 superstars that will be at the event this year, which began in 2018 at the Hyatt Regency in Schaumburg and is in the Chicago area for a third time. Sting, Rob Van Dam, Sky Blue are among those scheduled to attend, taking part in meet and greets, autograph sessions, and panel discussions. Thompson had a way of describing what this event is like to diehard fans of sports entertainment. He said it's like Woodstock, and talked about what it means to those hardcore rooters.
We had one last year in Nashville, and we set an all-time record with StarCast, and we're excited to bring it back to the spiritual home of StarCast. This will be our third StarCast in Schaumburg, Illinois. This, to me, is the home of StarCast, and really, for all intents and purposes, All Elite Wrestling, the big challenger brand for WWE, that first show that ran here called All In 2018 was sort of the proof of concept for All Elite Wrestling. So this is sort of, you know, before they were stars, the show before the show. And it still means that. And it means a lot for fans to not only be able to come together and see each other, because there's been a lot of relationships formed at StarCast, but to just sort of have that velvet rope lifted where they get access to some of their favorite wrestlers that they normally only see on TV.
See more on StarCast 6 by going to the story below or WGNTV.com. Larry Hawley, WGN News Now.